गुड मॉर्निंग। द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज पाउडर मेटलर्जी प्रोसेस। सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज पाउडर प्रोडक्शन। ओके, सो पाउडर प्रोडक्शन देर आर थ्री मेजर मेथड्स टू प्रोड्यूस पाउडर फ्रॉम मेटल। ओके, सो फर्स्ट वन इज वॉटर और गैस एटोमाइजेशन, सेकेंड इज सेंट्रिफ्यूगल ऑटोमाइजेशन एंड थर्ड इज रोटेटिंग इलेक्ट्रोड। ओके, so in first case water or gas atomization, in which we melt the liquid, we will the metal in liquid form, and then we will spray this liquid metal on water jacket, or we will spray this liquid metal in air. Okay, so when this liquid metal comes in the contact with water or gas or air, then it gets solidifies at faster rate, and the spray particles solidifies and we will get a metallic powder. Okay, so how to make powder from metal, solid metal? So first melt the solid metal and pour into the spraying gun, and then spray this liquid metal using compressed air, and spray in a water jacket or spray in a air, okay, or gas. So when it comes in the contact with air or gas or water, it will get solidifies and you will get a solid metal particles. So this is first method. Second method is centrifugal atomization, in which we will melt the solid metal and convert it into liquid metal. Okay, and this liquid metal by centrifugal action or by rotating at very high speed, this liquid particle comes outward, and we will get a solid particles or solid particles in powder form. Okay, the process, only there is a difference of process. So in first case we will spray the liquid metal in air or in a water jacket with the help of compressed air. But in second case we are not using compressed air. Okay, we are rotating the object or we are rotating the disc in which liquid metal is there, and by this means of this rotation or rotation very high speed, the liquid particles comes outside this chamber, and we will get a liquid solid particles or solid metallic powder at outer side. Okay, only the difference is in method of application. Third is the rotating electrode. So in third case we are using rotating electrode for creating powder. In rotating electrode type we are using electric arc gun or plasma gun. So the basic function of this electric arc gun or plasma gun to heat the metallic bar or to heat the consumable bar. Okay, so consumable bar is fed against this electric arc or plasma gun, and it is also rotated at very high speed. So because of this high speed rotation and because of this hot plasma gun, metal melts, and with higher RPM of this consumable bar, the metallic powder or scrap is generated or prepared, and which is forcefully collected at outer bin. Okay, so this is the basic principle in this powder preparation or powder production. Okay, the third type is near about rotating electrode is as simple as machining a soft material using hard material. So we are feeding soft material against hard material, and with the help of a relative moment we are creating chips. Okay, chips means metallic scrap part of metal, soft metal. So this, in this third type, this is similar to machining. Okay, and we are getting chips or microchips at the end. Okay, next processes are roll crushers and ball mills. So roll crushers means there are two rolls. In between these two rolls, we are feeding a metallic objects or metals. Okay, and with this crusher, this metal solid metals get converted into a solid metallic powder of minimum or less diameter. Okay, so using these two rolls, big rolls or crushers, we crush the metallic stones into fine metallic powder. So, and next one is ball mill. Okay, in ball mill there are some hard material like abrasives are there, and in between in this mill we are placing a big stones of metals. Okay, and when we rotate this ball mill at higher RPM, okay, or tumbled this mill, then the big grains of metals comes in the contact with abrasive particles, and there will be a friction or there will be a relative moment between abrasive particles and metallic stones. So because of that relative motion and friction, we will get solid metallic powder at the end of this process. So these are some basic techniques to create metallic powder. Okay, so most common method is using a spray gun. Okay, metallic liquid metal is poured in a spray gun, and by using this spray, okay, we will get a metallic powder. Roll crusher is also commonly used. Okay, so these are some methods of powder preparation. Some other methods of powder preparation are chemical reduction of particulate compound, then electrolytic deposition, then pulverization or grinding of brittle materials, then thermal decomposition, then precipitation from solution, then condensation of metal wafers. So these are some commonly used techniques or methods to produce powder. Okay, next one is powder particles. So how powder particles are classified or look like? So first one is one dimensional particles. Okay, so first is acicular or irregular. So you can have such type of particles or such type of particle if it is in one dimension. Okay, only one dimension is there, only length is there. Next, in two dimension we will have a surface area. Okay, so flake like or dendritic like particles are found, okay, in this two dimensional type. And in three dimensional you can have surface area plus thickness. Okay, surface area plus thickness, spherical, which is less commonly found. So rounded, it is more commonly found. And this irregular is there, then porous there, angular is there. So there are number of size and shapes of particles. Okay, next step is sorting or sieving. So first step is powder preparation is over. Now how to sieve or how to sort the particles? Okay, so there is a grains. Okay, there is a grains, bigger grains, smaller grains, when we prepare a particles or powder. Okay, so to sort different grains, we will use this type of sieve, okay, or mesh. Okay, so this is a sieve or these are mesh. So we have set this, we have said the length and width of this mesh. Okay, so how we decide this length and width? If you want for example 10 or 100 micrometer diameter particle should enter from this sieve, and more than 100 should not be there. Okay, so we will set this length and width 100 100, okay, or 101 or 101. Okay, when we keep 101 101, then less than 101 will pass from this, okay, and more than or bigger than 101 micrometer diameter will be on the sieve or on the mesh, okay. They will not entered in the from the this mesh, okay. They will be on the mesh or on the sieve only, okay. So by this way you can classify or you can sort the particles, okay. So small diameter particle will enter from the sieve or mesh and bigger particles will be on the sieve only, okay. Then you need to again crush or again prepare powder from this bigger grains, okay. So this is next process, sorting or sieving. Next is blending or mixing. So this is next process in which binders and additives are added, okay. So blending a coarser fraction with finer fraction ensures that the interstices between large particle will be filled out. So powder of different metals and other materials may be mixed in the order to impact special physical and mechanical properties through metallic alloying elements, okay. So mostly copper, iron are added, which creates stronger bonding between different particles, okay. Sometimes wax, sometimes other plastic or other any materials are added to create a stronger bonding between all the particles. So lubricant may be mixed to improve the powder's flow characteristics, okay. Some lubricants such as oil, wax, okay, are added to create or to make material or to improve the material's characteristics. Next, binders such as wax or thermoplastic polymers are added to improve the grain strength. Sintering aids to add accelerate densification on heating. Okay, we will see this on next slides. Okay, so binders and additives are mostly added to improve some mechanical physical properties of metal and also to create a stronger bond between all the particles present there. This is next step. So several blending or mixing devices. So first one is a rotating drum, second one is this rotating drum, okay. Second one is this rotating double cone, third one is screw mixer, and fourth one is blade mixer. Okay, so these are the four different methods used to make proper dough. Okay, so first we will add our metallic powder in this chamber, okay, any chamber, and then we will add some binders and additives there, okay. So after addition of all these, we will then move or rotate, okay, all these mechanisms. So by this rotation of this mechanism, what will happen, these two metals, metallic powder and additives or blenders, mixed well, okay, or mixed properly. So after proper mixing, then we will create a dough of this mixture and we will place this mixture's dough in a die, okay, or on a die, okay, upper die or lower die. And then we will use our mechanical, hydraulic or pneumatic press to compress this mixture, okay. And after compression we will heat this mixture, okay. So next step is compression or compaction. So this is next step, blending, mixing. Next is compaction. So in compaction we will place, for example, these are metallic powder plus adders and binders. So we have placed our mixture here in between lower die. This is a lower die and this is upper die, between lower die and upper die. So lower die, I have fixed the lower die, or you can move both the dies, okay. So in this case we have moved the both the dies here. We have moved this die, and because of this movement you can see the void space between these particles. So there is a void space. If you see here, if you see in between these two, there is a void space, there is a blank space, there is a white space. Okay, so reduce the white space, we have increase the pressure in between this die. So because of that higher pressure, you can see the gases between or the free air between these particles will be removed, and we again compressed here. Okay, so by this compression, you can see there is a negligible, very little void space is there. So because of that void space, there is a porous material. Okay, so because of that, this void space only, material gets, or material is porous. So this is compaction process. So press powder into a desired shape and size in a dies using hydraulic or mechanical press. Then pressed powder is known as green compact. Then cold compaction is with 100 to 900 MPa megapascal to produce green body. So die processing, cold isostatic pressing, rolling and gravity are the methods. Then injection molding, small or complex part. So injection molding is also one of the process. It is used to compact or press the material. Okay, this is compaction. So you can see the porosity reduces when we increase the pressure. Okay, porosity means number of holes, pores in a material. Okay, when we compress at very high pressure, then the holes diameter reduces. Okay, porous hole diameter reduces or will be negligible, means no spaces will be there. Okay, when we increase the pressure of this lower end and upper die, in between this lower and upper die, so more material get compressed and we will get compressed material. Okay, with minimum porosity or minimum holes or minimum void spaces. So as material is more porous, there is a tendency to scatter it out, means particles will scatter when it falls, means brittleness is also there. Next is sintering. So sintering is nothing but a heating, but in this heating process there is no oxygen present or negligible oxygen present. Okay, so why there is no oxygen? When we heat the metal, because of that oxygen, material gets, or material will, the tendency of material, it will burn. Okay, so there should not be any burning there. Okay, to avoid the burning, we are not using oxygen, or we are not heating in presence of oxygen. So by heating, what will happen? This you can see in this figure. So first, there is such type of mixture or such type of bonding is there in between particles. When we heat, what happens? This boundary, this is our grain. So this is outer is boundary. So this grain boundaries starts melting. Okay, and when it melts, it is attached with another metal. Okay, so it will also melt. This is also melt. So because of this melting, see, boundary get melts and it will attach to one another. Okay, next, when we heat again, so there is more melting takes place and more strong bond between this particle 1, 2, 3 will be there. Okay, and we are heating and also compressing. So because of heating and compression, you will get a very good bond or strong bond in between these particles or among the particles. Okay, so these are attached very strongly. So this is the process of sintering. So green compact obtained after compaction is very brittle and low in strength. So green compact are heated in a controlled atmosphere furnace to allow pack metal powder to bond together. So part are heated to 0.7 to 0.9 of melting temperature. Okay, for example, melting temperature of this mixture is 1000. So you need to heat 0.7 to 0.9 times of 1000. Okay, so this is sintering. So transform compacted mechanical bonds are too much stronger metallic bonds. Okay, so only compaction will not give you a proper product. So after compaction or compaction plus sintering will be done simultaneously to get a strong metallic product. So these are the three stages of sintering, we already discussed it. So first stage is temperature is slowly increased so that all the volatile material in the green compact that would interface the good bonding is removed. Then rapidly heating this stage may entrap the gases and produces the high internal pressure which may be fractured in compact. Second stage is a high temperature stage. So third stage is sintered product is cooled in a controlled atmosphere, prevent oxidation and thermal shocks. Gases commonly used for sintering H2N2 and inert gases or vacuum. Okay, so these are the three main steps. First is this metal, then heated, and third stage is cooled down. Okay. Then compaction, sintering, combined stage. So this is most commonly used. Then simultaneous compaction plus sintering is done. Pressurized medium is inert gas and 100 megapascal pressure is used most commonly and at 1100 degree centigrade. So produces compact with almost 100% density. Good metallurgical bonding between particles and good mechanical strength. Then uses are super alloys components and aerospace industries. Final desification step of WC cutting tools means tungsten carbide tools and powder metallurgy tool steels. Okay, so this is most common uses of compaction plus sintering combined stage. Next step is finishing steps. Okay, now our product is ready. Now is finishing. So the porosity of this fully sintered part is still significant. Okay, when we sintered it, then still there is a porosity. The 4 to 15% porosity is available or is there. So density is often kept intentionally low to preserve the interconnection porosity for bearing filters, acoustic barriers, and battery electrodes. So most commonly, porosity is required when we use this metal in bearings. Okay, so because of that porosity, our this lubricant will goes to the required parts or required elements. Then however, to improve the properties, finishing process are needed. Heat treatment, impregnation of heated oil and infiltration with metals or machining to tighter tolerance is the finishing processes. So first is heat treatment. Okay, so to improve some mechanical, thermal or physical properties, heat treatment is oftenly done after completed the sintering process. So there is a heat treatment process after finished product. Then impregnation of heated oil. So heated oil is added on this metal. Okay, and when so most commonly in bearing, impregnated powder metallurgy product is used. So infiltration with metals. So infiltration means we will melt the copper or ferrous any other materials and we will pour this melted material on the porous product, porous powder metallurgy product. So when we add this heated or melted material on this porous product, then what will happen? The porosity of this metal, porosity of this product reduces. Okay, so this liquid metal fill up the gap of this porous material. And last one is machining to tighter tolerances. So sometimes machining is openly used or machining is done to make material or to make to reduce the to make material at tighter tolerances. So powder metallurgy flow chart is there. So first is metal powder preparation. So atomization, reduction, electric deposition, then carbonyls, and then communicating mechanical alloying is the process to make powder. Next is additives and lubricant addition and proper blending. After blending, we will have cold compaction and hot compaction. So pressing, isostatic pressing, rolling, extrusion, injection molding are the cold compaction process. Hot compaction, isostatic pressing, then sintering, atmospheric or vacuum. So we will heat the metal after compaction. And last one is secondary processes and finishing operation: coining, forging, machining, heat treatment, impregnation and infiltration and plating. So these are the secondary or finishing processes. So this is flow chart of powder metallurgy process. First is metal powder preparation, then additive addition, blending, then compaction, then sintering, and then finishing products, finishing steps.